Okay, by the end of this video, you're gonna know exactly if you have low vitamin D levels, given that you tested them. But you might have tested them and maybe your doctor said, you are totally fine, you don't have to supplement. That's actually pretty common. But this might not be the case. I'm going to tell you why and how to find out. I'm also going to tell you how much you have to take to reach a certain optimal level, when to take it, which form to take, and all those things. So, okay, vitamin D, it's so good for so many things. Actually, I checked on PubMed. It's such a well-studied substance. I heard it's the most studied substance in the world. So there are really like literally 89,000 studies about vitamin D. And they have discovered so many benefits for bone health, for diabetes, for heart disease. It reduces the cancer risk. It reduces the risk for autoimmune diseases. It can help with depression, anxiety, and other mood disorders. Hormonal imbalances, so many things. I mean, it's literally endless. It seems vitamin D is really plays a key part in so many processes in the body. So it's important that we have our levels up and good to prevent disease. And it's especially also important if you suffer from anything like fatigue or anything, then any health condition, it will practically benefit. So it's very important that you are at the optimal levels. Okay, so how can you find out if you need vitamin D? It's very simple. It's a blood test that you can go to a lab, you can take a private blood test, or you can see if your doctor's gonna do it. But you have to read your test yourself also. Yeah, your doctor is gonna say if your levels are 21 nanograms per deciliter, your doctor's gonna say your levels are fine, but 21 is actually pretty low. So it's like above 21. All is good, and under 20 would even a doctor would say yes, you have to supplement. So the optimal range is more like 60 nanograms per deciliter or 75, and it can even be a bit higher. It could be up to 90. So anything under 100 is fine. You don't want to go too high, so that's why we have to test it every once in a while to see where we are, and we have to more or less know what kind of dose is gonna bring us to the ideal levels. Okay, so let's say you weigh about 65 kilos, I think this is about 140 pounds, and your blood levels at the moment are 20, or maybe they're even under, and you decide to supplement. How long would it take you? How long would it take you to fill up those levels? That's the question, yeah? Because if you take, let's say, a 5,000 international units of vitamin D per day, it takes a whole year to fill your levels up, to get to those 60 nanograms per deciliter in your blood levels. So this is a long time, yeah? If you have any chronic issues or any health issues at all, then we want to accelerate this process a little bit. And I have to mention, I mean, the official recommended dose of vitamin D to take daily is actually just 600 units per day. Yeah, and for people, I think, older than 70, it's 800 international units per day. So this is a pretty conservative dose. Yeah, it's better than nothing. But with that dose, I mean, I just said if you would take 5,000 units, this is multiples of 600, even then it would take you probably a full year to get up to those ideal blood levels that we want to see. Yeah, you have to also check, actually, when I say blood levels of 60, of 20, I mean nanogram per deciliter, because there's also a different unit that is commonly used. It's nanomoles per liter. So you have to carefully check on your blood results in which unit and you can, of course, convert the units. Yeah, there are simple vitamin D calculators online, and you can calculate the equivalent in nanogram per deciliter. Yeah, so we're talking about the nanogram per deciliter, because it varies in those two different units. Okay, so the official dose is way too low, and they're actually even thinking about changing the official recommendation, which is very positive and very good. I mean, I think they're going to change it at least to 2000 a day. Better would be to 5000. And as I said, even if you are very low in vitamin D, 20 or under, it's going to take you up to a year. Of course, it depends on many different factors. So you might get there earlier. You know, for some people this might be 6 months, for others this is 12 months. So it's really a wide range. That's why it's good to retest it, like after 6 months or between 6 months to a year, it's good to retest and to see where you actually ended up with your levels. Because if you are at this optimal level, you know, this is the difference, normal levels and optimal levels. Yeah, normal is above 20, but optimal is around 60-75. Yeah, this is the levels that have found to be good for the results you want, that it has a benefit on your health and prevents diseases and all that. Yeah, so we want to aim for this higher blood levels of 60-75. Yeah, so so you calculated the right amount, you take 5,000 a day, it takes up to a year, that's a pretty long time. So what we can do to shorten this process a little bit is we take a loading dose for a while. Yeah, a safe loading dose, this is also already tried in many studies. I can link to a resource below if you want to read that, is that you can use safely a loading dose of 25,000 units per day for, let's say, 10 days to 1 or 2 months, let's say a month, yeah, between 10 days and a month, you could take this loading dose of 25,000, and then actually, and after that, you would take your normal dose of probably around 5,000, but it also depends on the person. It could be 4,000, it could be, you need 7,000 to really sustain those levels once you reach them. So you take a loading dose and then switch after a month to a maintenance dose, and you reach your goal way, way faster. So basically after a month you have reached, or 1 to 2 months, you have reached your desired levels of 60-75. Yeah, you could take higher doses. Actually, they have experimented with doses like up to, I don't know, 500,000, 600,000 per day, but for a very short time. But then some of the vitamin D gets broken down more quickly, and yeah, you kind of, nothing bad's gonna happen, but you waste a bit of vitamin D. Let's say it's better to spread it out, because of course you can't just absorb so and so much. Yeah, it depends. Some gets lost. No? So the amount of vitamin D that you consume is not all ending up in your blood, in your tissues, where the body needs it. Yeah, this is also a thing, of course. If you take a loading dose of 25,000, you're not going to retest blood levels after this month of taking this high dose, because in your blood levels will be high, they will spike for a while, and they might be way higher than recommended for a short while, but this is just because it takes a while until the vitamin D gets absorbed into the tissues. Yeah, so then you have just a lot of vitamin D still circulating in the blood, and slowly, slowly it saturates your tissues in the whole body, and it goes where it's needed. Yeah, so don't do the test like right after a month after taking a loading dose for a month. This wouldn't make sense. Wait like 6 months or so, then you know. And after testing and retesting, again, you know, okay, if I take 5,000, I can maintain those levels of 60-75 in my blood, and then I know exactly my dose and exactly what I have to take. So most people really have to take it every day to keep up. It doesn't matter at all, you know, if you skip a day or several, it doesn't matter, because it's not a water soluble vitamin. It's actually fat soluble. It dissolves in fat. So that means your body holds onto it in the fat tissue. It's not like, let's say, for example, the B vitamins or vitamin C. You take them and you basically pee them out, yeah, at the end of the day or during the day. No? So you have to take them every day so you can really maintain those blood levels of vitamin C or B vitamins. You have to consume them every day in your food. But vitamin D or, for example, vitamin E, vitamin A and omega-3, your body holds on to them once it's saturated and you have taken a high enough dose. Yeah, so it's no problem to skip a day. It's not that crucial. Okay, so that means we best take the vitamin D together with our food. Yeah, with food that contains some fat. Yeah, so let's say with your lunch or dinner, maybe with your biggest meal of the day, that would be the best, or just with lunch or dinner, when you also eat some fat. So the fat digestion actually gets really kicked in your body and is really working. And so the vitamin D gets also metabolized and digested. Yeah. So take the vitamin D together with your food. at any time of, I mean, the time of the day doesn't play a role, but it's, yeah, with the food would be ideal. You can take it together with your other vitamins that dissolve in fat, like omega, like I said, omega, vitamin E, vitamin A. Yeah, so it basically comes in two forms, yeah. It comes, it's oily, so I said, yeah, it dissolves in fat, so they put it in oil, actually. So usually it's olive oil or coconut oil or something like that. So it comes in liquid form, which is very practical. You have to read the label carefully, because sometimes one drop is 1,000 units. Sometimes one drop is 5,000 units. So you have to, of course, know how much you get in every drop, and then you can easily calculate your dose. It comes also in capsules, and those are little, not your regular capsules. Those are those gel caps. They are soft and squishy, very easy to swallow. And also you have to check. Those come in different, like 5,000 per capsule, 20,000 or even 50,000 per capsule. So yeah, just read the label and find out how much is in there. Yeah, okay, so that's basically what I recommend, to take a loading dose for a while and then to switch to maintenance dose. So taking maybe 25,000 for a month and then switching to 5,000. Of course, it depends what levels you start with, so it's good to talk to somebody about that. But that's basically, yeah, it's a safe procedure to do it that way. And there is actually a connection also between magnesium and vitamin D. It seems they play a role, they're kind of synergistic, we say, or they play a role in absorption. They help each other to get to the places where it's needed. And some recommend to take magnesium together with vitamin D. I mean, a fact is vitamin D and magnesium are the two most common deficiencies in the modern Western world, let's say, or probably worldwide, actually. Because, of course, you know, we get the vitamin D from the sun. It's not so much in our food. It is in fatty fish and things like that a little bit, but we mainly get it from the sun. And of course, we don't work outside anymore. We have, yeah, changed our lifestyle and everything. So most of us are maybe inside most of the day. And yeah, we simply don't get enough sun, or we use sunscreen, or of course it plays a factor if you have dark skin or lighter skin. The lighter skin is easier to penetrate for the sun and to produce the vitamin D. So there are certain risk factors also in that direction. Now, if you are overweight, the vitamin D gets kind of stuck in the fatty tissue and doesn't get to where it's needed. So there are some risk factors, but basically the main factor is actually not getting enough sun exposure. And many of us don't get much sun exposure, or live in climates where, yeah, there's not so much sun. So, yeah, it's really a very common deficiency. It's actually that probably 90% of people are not in this optimal range of 60 to 75% in modern societies that work inside and everything. And the second most, or yeah, together with vitamin D, the most common deficiency is actually magnesium deficiency. So it's anyway a good idea to take it. Yeah. And I made a video about that. So you can, yeah, click on the link that appears on the screen, and you are taken to my video about magnesium, because it's the same thing. There are many misconceptions about the dose and how to take it, when to take it, and those kind of things. So yeah, just to help with more founded information. Yeah, so vitamin D is really, it's such a highly studied substance with so many studies, I told you, and yeah, so it's a safe substance to take. There is some concern, you know, you shouldn't overdose for a long while. Of course, you shouldn't stay on this maintenance dose like forever, on the loading dose forever. Yeah, you don't take the 25,000 for a long time. That would be not good. But you can safely take it for up to a month, and then you take your maintenance dose, which is maybe around 5,000, depends on your body weight and everything. Okay, so tell me in the comments what you thought of this video, if you have learned something new. I read all the comments. Check out my channel. I have more videos about herbs and women's health. So yeah, I hope to see you in the next video. Ciao.